Right, the next thing is we're going to enter into one of the most important section of the video editing in Resolve, which is the color correction and color grading. Okay, so let's say at this point we're going to treat this coloration at the beginner level, so everything is going to be very basic. If you've not added coloration to your footage before, this is going to be very basic. So it's just going to be the most basic color correction video you've ever seen. So this is just simply for beginners. If you are an advanced user, then I recommend you try another video, but this is going to be strictly for beginners. So select, assuming we are at the editing tab, if you want to start your color correction, all you need to do is come to the color page over here by just clicking on color, and it is going to bring you to the color page down here. So at the beginning, this might look a little bit scattered and confusing and so professional to a beginner, but there's nothing to worry about. It's just going to be, I'm going to explain the basic concept over here of what you will have and what you can use to play around with your footage to have the best experience possible. So at this point, you will have the primary color wheels, which is at the bottom left over here. There are different color wheels and they add different effects to your video. So all you need to do is to just understand their basic functions. So what we have is, sometimes we have our blacks. We can increase or decrease our blacks, which you can do from the lift over here. The lift over here is just representing the blacks, okay, the dark part of the video, and the gamma is just the mid-range, okay, and then we have the gain, which is representing the highlight part of the video, and then we have the offset, which talks about the image or the video as a whole. Any correction is going to be on the coloration or the image, considering the image as a whole. That's what the offset does. And we have different kind of, and we have small wheels over here. We call them the master wheels. Okay, they can be used to tweak in the controls, different controls, to bring in different kind of effect into our video. So as you hover over, as you drag and move, tweak the master controls, you're going to see the effects on your video clip over here. So just pay attention as I explain the basics. This is the custom curves. You have it for all the coloration, the yellow, the red, the blue, and the green coloration. You can alter them accordingly. And down here we have the color scopes. This is very interesting if you understood the basic, because sometimes you don't have to trust your eyes when it comes to coloration. They can help you to guide you when it comes to what you should add and whether your color is peaking, whether you are losing some data. All these color scopes can help you to have an idea of what is happening. Sometimes you cannot trust your eyes. So let's try to look at the picture clearly, or the video clearly, and let's say it's a bit raw from the camera, but we want to make the darkest part of it appear darker, like my hair over here and this screen, computer's keyboard, and then this dark part to appear very much darker thereabout. So you can increase this by just coming over to the lift, which is the darkest part. So if you play around with the lift, you can select this dot over here, and once you try to move it around, you can see the dark part of the image is moving. Okay, you can try to tweak it around, and you can see you can change coloration accordingly to any color of your choice. And don't worry about all these changes in the darkest part. You can always double click on it to reset it, to bring it back to normal, or you can come over here to this small arrow and undo or reset everything to normal. Like right now, it's already reset to normal. So, but then while we want to tweak, we just want to bring in the blacks, to increase the blacks so that it becomes to appear blacks, and the whites to appear white. So you just come over here to this master wheel and you can tweak it around. So let's say we can increase, and you can see the blacks are gradually popping out and they are appearing to be really black. So just pay attention to the wheels over here so that it stays within. If it touches and try to go over this very selection, it means you are losing some data. So whatever you are going to do, we just tweak it a little without having too much of the color scopes going out of range. So you have only your blacks coming out to be very clearly. You can see my hair now appearing very black, and the other sections also appearing very black, while still maintaining these scopes within range. So this is how to add some black, and then you can add some white if you want. So let the white part of it appear white. So let's say we can come over here and just tweak it a little bit so that it appears white. The white part will appear white, and you can see it coming out. So you just be mindful of this tweaking so that you don't lose much of the data. but just have it a little bit so that you can see the white part coming out to be white. If you put it to be too much, then it's going to glow just like so, and you are losing a lot of data. So you can just bring it back to normal, but just make sure that the white is white, just like so, something like this. I think it's okay. Then what I usually do is I used to play with the saturation as well. I can add little saturation or reduce the saturation as you so wish accordingly. So you can come over here. I can have this saturation. Once you come over here, you can see the mouse changing into two arrows. You can just try to tweak it a little bit. You can reduce the saturation a bit, or you can add it to make it more cinematic a little bit. So you can see we can add a little bit of saturation and you can see the effect while still paying attention to the scopes in the panel. So you can see we can add a little bit of the saturation so it appears. So what you can do at any given point to see the effects of what you have done is you can always come over here to this bypass color grades and fusion effects. Once you click, you can see the before and you can see the after. You can see the before and you can see the after, and then you can see and you appreciate the little you have done. The next thing I usually touch is I make sure I'm on the white color selected over here, and I click to select 2 points because I usually make an S shape. Okay, so once you move a little bit up, it's going to increase the lighting. You can see, okay, you can increase the lighting, and you can bring it down to decrease the lighting. You can bring it down to bring out the blacks also clearly. So I think you can see it coming out a little bit clearly, and the picture is now very much better and professional. You can do the same if you notice that there's more of red, you want to reduce the red coloration in the picture. You can do that as well. You can just play around with it. If you do it too much, you're going to see the effect, but then it's just going to be very little so that you can see it, the impact, very clearly. And if you have noticed that there is too much green also, you can reduce it accordingly. Okay, you can select and reduce the green color so you can pop out a little, the image can pop out a little bit. So it's just up to your discretion to just play around with it, but right now I think I'm okay with what I have. And you can see the preview over here regardless of what clips you are on. Whichever clips you are on, you can see the preview also over here and from the canvas as well. So at any given point, try to look at the before and the after, the before and the after, so you can appreciate what you have done. So this is basically how to do anything within. And at this point, if you want to undo any of the changes at this point, you can just come over here and click on the undo button over here and reset button over here and to have them reset. Okay, so you can reset any portion of the clip. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.